could see us being the worst team in the NBA. I think the Atlanta Hawks have some of the best core pieces, probably the best core teams in the NBA. The management are doing very, 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 very well with that team. Having Trae Young, John Collins, and all these other young guys with them, you know, they're going to be a really good team. Oh, you got Sabonis. I got Sabonis in my last video. If you didn't see that one, I will link that video up in a cue card in the top right hand corner of the screen. If you haven't seen the last video, I very much recommend you watch it. But yeah, the Atlanta Hawks are a good young team. Definitely a team that could probably maybe beat any team in the NBA. They're one of those dangerous young teams where you don't really know what's going to happen. You know, like I said, they could either probably make the playoffs next year, like a 7th, 8th seed, or they could, again, just be a very bad team. Looks like we're doing pretty good so far, actually. And that car outside is very loud. Sorry. Center, but like I said, I really want to go after DeMarcus Cousins in the free agency. And I already put Trae Young and all the core guys on the no trade list, so that's why you're not seeing any trades for them, because I put them on the no trade list because I really want to keep the core together. Alright, so 6, not bad. Steal a game. 37% from the 3, not bad. Oh god, John Collins is not doing so hot. I would at least wanted to average at least 15 points, but he's not doing it. Oh wow, Jabari Parker though. Doing very well. Very, very, very well. DeAndre Hunter. See, this Marcus Gasol, be a good center to pick up. Montrezl Harrell. I'm pretty sure Kuzma and all them would probably get re-signed. But I guess we'll just have to see. Even Brandon Ingram would be a really good pickup. Check out the standings in the Chris Paul got NBA first team. Wow, that's crazy. Anybody on the Hawks? Probably not. Dang. Okay, well, like I said, we didn't make the playoffs. But our boy Trae Young averaged 21. It's almost 7. Very good. Very, very, very good. John Collins got a little better. But I don't know. If he keeps this up next season, I might trade him. Honest, and then Jabari Parker did really good for us this year. I'm very surprised. Same thing with DeAndre Hunter, and then Cam Reddish as well. Very good. And then Kevin Herter's going to be probably our starting shooting guard, maybe even next season, but we'll just have to see. Let's simulate the playoffs. Looks like the Lakers and the Clippers might meet each other in the second round there. Houston. Over in the East, you have the Indiana Pacers, the 8th seed, making it to the conference finals, but it looks like Boston's going to sweep their way into the finals. Yep. Come on, Lakers. Yeah, Boston Laker final. And so we have the 5th best odds. Why is it like that? But yeah, and the Celtics also have a first round pick from Sacramento, so dang, they're gonna be good. So let's see, let's just skip it. Oh, we got the 2nd pick, let's go. And we also got the 7th pick from Dallas. Yo, that's awesome, that's great. Let's go. Alright, so we could probably combine those two together to make a pretty decent pickup in the draft. So let's see here. Okay, so we could, I guess, just get a pick and get, like, LaMelo like we did last video. But like I said before, I think I might just trade the picks. guess we can trade one of these guys for a backup small forward. I guess we can just make Cameron a small forward. That'll work. And then we can just have DeAndre Hunter as a starter. And then we need a backup center if we get Boogie Cousins. And then a backup power forward, so. Oh, I know we don't need a backup because we already have Jackson Hayes. Here, we just need a backup power forward. Let's make Kimmerish a small forward, which actually makes him better than DeAndre Hunter. Yikes, they're going to be battling for position there. Alright, perfect. So let's get a backup point guard and backup power forward. Oh, wait, we actually need to get rid of our cap holds. And I just basically went through, filled out the rest of the roster. So, as you can see, we got DeMarcus Cousins here on a very good contract. Well, it doesn't matter because we're only doing this season, but it's not that bad of a contract. And then we got Noah Vonleh as our backup power forward and Austin Rivers as the backup point guard, so that's not too bad. And then just to fill out the roster, we got Aaron Baines here, who's a very popular player around the NBA. And then we got the legend Carmelo, and we're going to win. Carmelo, we're gonna get him a ring. We're gonna make Carmelo get a ring, and then we got Wes Chandler also on the bench. So it's a very good team, probably the most well balanced team I've had in a while. I mean, we got a lot of 80s, 290s, and almost 90 with Boogie Cousins. Yeah, this team's gonna be deadly on the perimeter defense with Victor Oladipo and DeAndre Hunter. We got Boogie. Hopefully Boogie can, you know, be back to his regular form, which would be nice. So, yeah, let's just kind of just jump into it, and I'll just do this thing that I always do whenever I do rebuilds, is make all the bench players have team chemistry. Trying to get Jackson Hayes for us from us, but I'm not gonna give him up. a very good team built with him. John Collins, again, not doing as well as I hoped. Like I said, if we weren't doing so well, I might have traded him. DeAndre Hunter not doing so well either. And then Cam Reddish. And Kevin Herter off the bench. Oh, for some reason, he's not even getting any minutes. Why is that? Oh, wow. Okay, so our bench is just super stacked, apparently. So Kevin Herter doesn't even need minutes, but I'm going to give him minutes. So sorry there, Austin Rivers, but let's give Kevin Herter some minutes. Noah Vonleh, 6 points. That's kind of okay. Oh, look at that. His per 36 is 18 and 10, basically. Yeah, I'm definitely glad we got him for that pick. And then Austin Rivers only doing 5 points, so. And then Carmelo's just chilling on the bench. Check out the standings for the rosters. We are number one in the NBA, actually. Wow, it's pretty impressive. And then Brooklyn with Kevin Durant is third. And the defending champs, the Boston Celtics, are second. Over here, you have the Pelicans and the Warriors. Wow. They are definitely doing very well. Then the Grizzlies. Are struggling. The Jazz are not doing good either. And then we have the Raptors. I might do a Raptors rebuild next, just because I feel like they'd be really tough to build, just because they don't have they have a lot of cap space in their play, but they don't have a lot of cap space. And then, you know, Pascal Siakam, that'd be pretty cool to build a team around him. I might do that next. So yeah, I don't really want to mess with anything. We're doing very well. Our players are playing very well. I just gave Kevin Herter some more minutes, so hopefully that'll help our team out. And yeah, let's see if we can win a championship. Definitely, this is one of the teams where, if I did like I did before with the Phoenix Suns, this team could win a championship. You know, 8 out of the next 10 years. You know, the team is so young. I feel like it could definitely be possible. Gentlemen sweep. Yeah, guys, that's it.